The show is starting.
Sure, it's funny how things turn out, isn't it?
Turn out for the best.
Okay, come on, kids. Come on. Mary, you look beautiful.
Thank you, Courtney. You do, too.
Okay, it's time. Come on.
Break a leg?
Thank you, sweetheart.
Joe, come on.
Couple brewskis and head to a movie.
I think I'm gonna go through with this.
Good. Because I would have hated missing the opportunity of walking the most beautiful woman here down the aisle.
Oh, Frank.
Please, be seated. Victor and Mary have asked a few of their friends and loved ones to read a prayer from St. Francis of Assisi.
Lord, make us the instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us sow love.
Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is discord, union.
Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope.
Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy.
Lord, grant that we may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love.
For it is in giving that we receive. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned. And it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
Mary Scanlon, Victor Collins, join hands and declare your consent before God and His church. You may now read the vows that you've chosen.
Dearest Mary, I waited so long for you that I had begun to believe there was no such thing as true love. Finally, you were given to me like a miracle, like a single elegant star in the darkest of nights. From this day on, I promise to love you, to live with you, and laugh with you for as long as we both shall live.
I, Mary, choose you, Victor, to be my husband from this day forward, and never to take you for granted. Always to be so thankful of your presence in my life. And in the name of God, I give you my love, my heart, and my soul, till death do us part.
The rings?
Dearest Mary, this ring is a token of my love. I offer it with my heart, with my body, with all that I have and all that I am.
Well, my dearest Victor, with this ring I marry you. With my heart, my body, and every syllable of my soul.
I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
We did it.
We certainly did.
Everyone, I give you Victor and Mary Collins.
Those two stay out of trouble. Stay out of trouble.
This is really great.
Told you my mom rocked at this stuff.
Well, that's nice of you to say. Thank you, sweetie.
You're welcome. Punch! Come on!
You really outdid yourself, Courtney. My bridesmaid's dress looks great on you.
Oh, yes, well, I had to have it taken in, but it does look good, doesn't it?
Look at our options. We could go small, family kind of thing. Big 110-foot yacht. Hell, we can go to the Taj Mahal if you want.
Okay, well, I promise I won't be too picky.
You say that now, but we're knee-deep in these wedding plans, and you go haywire on me.
Okay, I admit I can be a teeny-weeny, tiny, teeny-weeny bit choosy, but what I mean is I can't go wrong because I'm marrying you.
That's right.
You gotta have punch at your wedding, too. And cake.
Of course, you always have punch and cake at weddings.
I can hardly wait. Come on, let's go.
Okay.
You haven't told Neil that we're not getting married.
I haven't exactly found the right time to tell him. Besides, I'm still getting used to the idea myself.
Well, it's better he hears it from you than somebody else.
Well, then I'll tell him that we had too many differences between us for us to stay together. The belief in each other being number one. You okay?
Enough about me. This is a beautiful wedding. And I'm so excited for you and Lucy. Congratulations.
You know, I know what you're going through. I went through it many, 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 many times myself. But, you know, here I am. I'm about to marry Lucy, and I couldn't be happier. Now, you have got these great qualities. And you're beautiful. And you got this great heart. And in the end, you're gonna be okay. I promise.
I'm really glad you can be here.
Yeah, me too. Well, you know, if it wasn't for you and Scott and Victor rescuing me in New York City, I don't know what would have happened to me.
Don't think about it. You're safe, and that's all that really matters.
Yeah. Well, actually, I'm more than safe. I'm very happy. Listen, it's not official yet, but I wanted to tell you. Scott asked me to marry him. And, I said yes.
It's wonderful. Congratulations.
Thanks. You know, it was so weird when I saw you walking down the aisle with Eve. I flashback to our wedding date. Well, you know, our almost wedding day. I can't believe this. Who would think a year later that we would be happy with other people?
Well, I guess I've learned a thing or two from you about being open to what the universe has to offer. Looks like we both took your advice.
Who I found?
Hey.
Hi.
Hi.
Lucy, welcome back to Port Charles. I am very glad to see you got out of DV's clutches in one piece.
You know, let's not go there. Let's not even talk about that man. Tonight is so wonderful for so many reasons, so that man's gone, okay?
Amen to that.
Oh!
What's going on in there?
Oh, it's Victor and Mary. Let's go.
Oh.
Unless I'm very much mistaken, I think they're getting ready to play our tune.
Really?
Would you like to dance, Mrs. Collins?
Why, I'd be delighted, Mr. Collins.
Music, maestro!
Oh, that is our music.
Oh, please visit.
Almost 20 years, and I do believe this is the happiest I've ever seen him.
Well, I know I have never seen Victor more content. What do you say? Why should my father have all the dance floor glory?
Oh, you do like to live dangerously.
I've had to learn.
Gail, where is Lee? Can you believe it? He had to go to Albany at the last minute for a deposition.
Oh. Well, let's hope he's back by Friday.
Yes.
Why? Wait a minute. What didn't you tell me? What's Friday?
Well, it's our 20th wedding anniversary.
And he will be back. Even have to fly to Albany and get him myself.
I just might take you up on that.
Grandma Gail, come dance with us.
Oh, dance with you? Well, I'd love to. Thank you. My goodness, I had no idea it had been 20 years for Lee and Gail. You know, maybe we should do something special for them.
It's a good idea, Audrey. Let me give it some thought.
Hmm.
Lucy, stop eating. Let's dance.
Oh.
Okay.
Come on.
Hey, would it be... would it be totally uncool to dance with your dear old dad?
Yes. But I would love to anyway.
Oh, come on.
I have a pretty interesting piece of news for you.
Scott and Lucy are engaged. What's your news?
Scott and Lucy are engaged.
Doesn't anyone in Port Charles keep secrets?
Apparently not. How do you feel about that?
I've been through a range of emotions in the last 12 months. I'm really, really happy that I'm with you. But I have to honestly say I do feel guilty that I ruined your wedding with Lucy.
Well, I've run the gamut of emotions myself in the last year. I can't say I'm disappointed about how things turned out.
Listen, Joe, I promised Karen that I wouldn't confront you, but I gotta tell you, I'm disappointed in you.
Well, then you obviously don't know the whole story.
What I do know is that you are hurting my daughter.
Karen bought into a bunch of lies.
So it's all her fault.
Someone else is responsible for all this garbage that has been dumped on me. It is Karen's fault for believing it.
Hey, so what you're saying is that who are you gonna
be? Scott!
You or her lion eyes? Is that what you're saying to me?
Scott, please, listen.
What?
This is not the time. This is not the place. Kevin's ready to make a toast. Come on.
That's what I wanted to know.
If I could have everyone's attention just for a moment.
Okay.
To my father, Victor, you are a source of wonder, joy, and complete surprise even to me. And I wish you an abundance of love and happiness.
Thank you.
Mary, I welcome you heartily to the Collins clan and all that comes with it. But I also tip my hat to my father, for he is a damn lucky man to have won the heart of a woman as beautiful and charming as you.
You're right.
You are an inspiration to us all. To Victor and Mary.
Here, here.
Thank you.
That means, huh?
Hey, Karen, are you okay? Yeah. I saw that roller derby move that Courtney put on you.
I've had enough of that girl.
Ugh. All right, listen, the car is ready. Have fun on your cruise.
Thanks.
Good luck.
Thanks for everything.
Now you take care of her. Just because I gave her away doesn't mean I gave her away, all right?
Mom.
Oh, no. I will have a good time.
Oh, Victor. You still owe me for this wedding.
Oh, yeah. All right.
All
right. You do realize what this means. This means it is all official now. There is absolutely no backing out.
Well, that thought never crossed my mind.
Better not have. Are you enjoying yourself?
Oh, you care. Well, it's my job to make sure all the guests have a good time. Mm-hmm. Even the ones who are rude enough to drop out of the wedding party at the last minute.
Courtney, it's a shame you didn't catch that bridal bouquet hard as you tried. If this whole wedding coordinating thing doesn't work out for you, you can always get a career in pro wrestling.
It's just as well you didn't catch it. Because if you were the next one to be getting married, the rest of us would have an awfully long way.
Courtney, you said you wanted to make sure all your guests were having fun. I'm gonna make your wish come true.
Gosh, I'm having fun now.
This turned out to be the perfect place for a wedding.
Good thing for us, Mary's priest wouldn't have anything to do with Victor.
Oh.
Are you still cold?
No, I just got a chill. Like someone walked over my grave. I've never been here before, but I just got the strangest feeling of deja vu. I wonder how many people were married her. Chris. imprisoned here. Buried here.
You can almost see the ghosts.
Almost.
Sadness and joy on your face at once. One look at you and I know exactly what I want to write for my next book.
Tonight, it's the very last Home Improvement ever in the 90-minute series finale. Then on the season finale of Spin City, supermodel Heidi Klum is back again, and she's not leaving without Mike. Spin City at a special time, ABC Tonight.